How's it going, everyone? It's Mannetjie Mannetjie here, and today, because of how epic they are, I decided to drop a quick guide on how to find some of the dopest Twinblades in Elden Ring. This is by no means rated in terms of stats, but purely how great the weapons look, as well as how badass their special abilities are. So let's jump right in!
Mannetjie Mannetjie!
The weapons this guide will be covering are Eleonora's Pole Blade, the Twin Knight Swords, and finally, the Godskin Peeler. I know, right? Epic. All of them can be found once you've reached the Altus Plateau region northeast of Raya Lucaria Academy. You don't need to go inside of the actual academy to access the region, but the first on our list requires that you're at least able to get through the academy's magic barrier. Speaking of which, the first on our list, Eleonora's Poleblade, and arguably the best looking, requires that you complete a relatively simple questline helping Bloody Finger Hunter, Yura. Yura can first be encountered southeast of the Church of Elle, quite close to the start of the game near the seaside ruins site of Grace, although this is completely skippable, considering it wasn't where I first encountered him. My first encounter with him was while approaching the entrance to Murkwater Cave, across the lake directly north of the previously mentioned seaside ruins Grace. While approaching the entrance, you'll be invaded by a Bloody Finger, and Yura will step in to help you not get your ass kicked, depending on how early you are in the game. After this encounter, you'll find a bloody sign on the ground after passing through the Raya Lucaria Academy magic barrier and warping to the main academy gate site of Grace in this area. Note that in order to do so, you'll need an Academy Glintstone key, which you'll be able to find over here hiding behind quite a large winged enemy. No spoilers here. Interacting with the bloody sign will pull you into Yura's world, where you'll be able to help him defeat another Bloody Finger, and he'll tell you about his mission to slay Bloody Finger Eleonora. After this encounter, the final time you'll encounter him will be at the Second Church of Marika, on the Altus Plateau, where you'll be invaded by Bloody Finger Eleonora herself. Defeat her, and a bloody pole blade is all yours, and man is it cool. Since you're already in the Altus Plateau region, you'll be able to make your way northeast, where you'll find the next two weapons on this list relatively close to each other. The first that you're likely to encounter will be the Twin Knight Swords, which you'll find on a burning corpse pile in this area, guarded by a bunch of very weird enemies. Do not trust them. You're right there, man? After you've mopped up that crowd, it's time for the fun bit. Follow the road southeast until you reach this area, and enter Dominula, the Windmill Village. The villages here are kinda creepy, so feel free to run straight past them all the way up to the top of the village, which is where you'll encounter...
Nope!
This guy. He's not the toughest boss in the world. He's not the toughest boss in the world, but he can hit pretty hard if you let him.
Okay.
Helicopter! Helicopter!
Once you've dealt with him, his weapon, the Godskin Peeler, is all yours. While the Twin Knight Swords is the easiest of these to get, Eleonora's Pole Blade and the Godskin Peeler are by far some of the coolest twin blades in the game. I'll shut up for a second and just let you guys enjoy. If you guys enjoyed this Elden Ring Twinblade guide, let us know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, all those YouTube-y sort of stuff. And let us know if you'd like to see more of this kind of content on the channel. Mannetjie Mannetjie out!